Hello class, this video are first topic for the final, so stock market. Take note class, stock market is one of the best or one of the most popular type of financial market. So even sa whole world or even dun sa mga ibang bansa, stock market is popular. So dito kumikita ng malaki yung mga broker or yung mga ibang individual, especially with the mga malalaking kumpanya. But take note class, this discussion is not the broad or hindi siya yung malalaman nyo talaga at the lahat ng aspect ng stock market. It's just only a general meaning of the stock market, and at the same time ito lang yung mga definition of terms and concepts in stock market. So as habang nag-aaral kayo sa accountancy, under accountancy program, so malalaman yung mga stock market. But hindi naman kayo lahat. Siguro, I don't think so. So let's start stock market. So what are stocks? So investing in stocks. So a share of stock in a firm represents ownership. A stockholder owns a percentage interest in a firm consistent with the percentage of outstanding stock held. So in every time class na meron kang or nag-invest ka ng pera sa isang kumpanya or sa isang korporasyon, so meron kang share of stock or you are one of the owner of a corporation. So investors can earn a return from stock in one of two ways. Either the price of the stock rises over time or the firm pays the stockholder dividends. So here class, yung investor or ikaw na may stock sa isang corporation or sa isang kumpanya, so pwede kang maka-income in two ways. Number one, yung stocks mo tumataas yung price. Naintindihan? So or di kaya yung corporation is nag-declare ng dividends. So let's have an example. ABS-CBN. Nung hindi pa nagsarang ABS-CBN, so syempre mataas yung kanyang price ng stocks. It's because nga sikat na sikat ang ABS-CBN by way of news. So news. So kasi kapag yung isang corporation kasi maganda ang performance, mataas yung presyo ng kanyang stocks. So if you have a share of stock sa ABS-CBN, so hinihintay mo na tumaas yung price ng stocks nila, so pwede mo nang ibenta. Or di kaya yung ABS-CBN mag-declare ng dividends. Ibig sabihin ng dividends, magbibigay siya ng income sa mga stockholder. So yun yung two ways how to gain a profit from stocks. Frequently, investors earn a return from both sources. Or di kaya class, dun sa dalawa, pwedeng yung stockholder magka-income. Tumataas yung kanyang share of stock or the price of share of stock. At the same time, nakakatanggap siya ng dividend. Stocks is riskier. So take note class, investing in stock is riskier. Malaki ang risgo than bonds. Because stockholder have a lower priority than bondholder when the firm is in trouble. Dividends are less assured and the stock price increases are not guaranteed. So take note class, malaki daw ang risk kapag mag-invest ka sa stocks. It's because nga kapag stocks kasi hindi mo control yung price ng stocks mo. And at the same time, yung bondholder kasi, fixed na yung matatanggap mo kapag meron kang bonds. O di kaya class, kapag stocks yung hawak mo sa isang korporasyon, ikaw yung pinaka-huling priority na babayaran. Let's say for example, yung si ABS-CBN, di ba nagsara na si ABS-CBN. So syempre, since nagsara ng ABS-CBN, lahat ng ari-arian ni ABS-CBN is i-divide na yan sa mga stockholder. But before si stockholder babayaran, uunahin muna yung mga creditor or yung pinagkakautangan ng korporasyon. Uunahin muna yung mga tao na may hawak na preference share. Uunahin yung mga taong may hawak ng bonds. And since ikaw na may stocks or common stocks, ikaw yung pinakahuling babayaran. Pero before class, bago yung pinagkakautangan, unahin mo munang bayaran yung gobyerno. So, by way of taxes. So, despite this risk, it is possible to make a great deal of money by investing in stocks. So, yun naman yung bawi doon class. Siyempre, sa stock, malaki ang income. So, kahit the higher the risk kasi, the higher the return. So, yun yung kasabihan. Kapag mataas yung return or mataas yung profit, mataas din yung risgo or the risk. Whereas, that is very unlikely by investing in bonds. Sa bonds kasi class, fixed na yung income mo. So, kung magkano lang yung ininvest mo sa isang kumpanya, i-multiply lang doon sa kanyang interest rates or interest yield. So, yun lang yung matatanggap ng investor. Hindi kagaya ng stocks kasi na kapag tumaas yung, hindi mo control yung price ng stocks. So, kapag mataas yung presyo ng stocks, so, pwede kang maka-income ng malaki. Another distinction between stock and bonds is that stock does not mature. So, take note class, sa bonds kasi is mayroong expiration ito. Naintindihan? Let's say, for example, mag-invest ka sa isang kumpanya. And then, ang ibibigay sa'yo is bonds or bondholder. You are a bondholder. Yung bondholder na yun is may expiration. Let's say, 10 years, 20 years. While sa stocks kasi class, hindi nagmamature, walang expiration ang stocks. Mag-expire lang ang stock kung yung corporation is mababankrupt or magsasara. So, yun lang yun. Pero habang buhay na buhay yung corporation, yung stocks is nandyan. Ownership of stock give the stockholder a certain right. So, kapag meron kang stocks or may hawak kang stock, meron kang certain rights regarding the firm. So, itong rights class is ibinibigay ito ng batas. One is the right of a residual claimant. Ibig sabihin, if you are a stockholder, you have the right or meron kang residual claimant. Ibig sabihin class, let's say for example, meron kang stocks ng San Miguel Corporation. Ibig sabihin, you are one of the owner of San Miguel Corporation. Naintindihan? So, yung rights na ibinigay sa'yo, yung isang computer o yung isang truck ng San Miguel Corporation, pwede mong sabihin na akin yun. Diba? So, that is residual claimant. Yun yung rights na sinasabi doon. Stockholders have a claim on all assets and income left over after all other claimants have been satisfied. So, ibig sabihin kas, if you are a stockholder, every assets of a corporation, of a company, you are the owner. Naintindihan? You are one of the owner. If nothing is left over, they get nothing. So, let's say for example kas, si ABS-CBN ngayon, nagsara na. So, nagsara na si ABS-CBN. Siyempre, lahat ng ari-ari, anong mangyayari doon sa mga ari-ari ang natira kay ABS-CBN? Unang-una doon class, yung priority is babayaran yung mga creditors or yung pinagkakautangan ng ABS-CBN. Ikalawang babayaran is yung gobyerno by way of taxes. Third na babayaran is yung preferred shareholders. Next na babayaran is yung mga bondholders. And kapag may matira pa, so yung mga common stocks or yung common shares na yung pinakahuling babayaran. So yun lang yung risk doon. Most stockholder have the right to vote for directors and on certain issues such as amendment to the corporate charter and whether new shares should be issued. So if you are a stockholder or meron kang hawak na share sa isang korporasyon, meron kang right to vote. So, let's say for example, malaki yung hinahawakan mong share sa isang korporasyon. So, pwede kang mag-vote or pwede mong iboto yung ibang tao na upo bilang board of director. So, di ba? kapag nakakapagnood kayo ng mga teleserye doon sa mga korporasyon, so yung board of director. Ibig sabihin, if you are a board of director, mataas yung rangko mo sa isang korporasyon. Let's say for example, sa San Miguel Corporation, Ramon Ang is the chairman and one of the board of director. So, siyempre, or the president rather, he is the president of the San Miguel Corporation. So, since he is the president, so meron siyang share sa isang sa korporasyon and meron siyang right to vote. Okay, next will be common stock versus preferred stock. So, let's distinguish the two. There are two types of stocks. So, ito class, a general type of common stocks. I know, stocks. Common at saka preferred. So, other name for common stock is ordinary shares. Although, may mga iba pang tawag sa shares. May treasury shares. So, pero yung general type talaga is common stock and preferred stock. So, a share of common stock in a firm represents an ownership interest in that firm. So, take note class, common stock ha. So, magkakaroon ka lang, you have the ownership interest in that firm. So, common stockholders vote, receive dividends, and hope that the price of their stock will be rise. So, this is the rights of the common stockholder. He has the right to vote. So, pwede siyang mag-appoint ng kanyang board of director. He can also vote for the president, corporate secretary, vice president. Next, receive dividends. So, pwede siyang he has the right to dividends. And hope that the price of their stock will rise. Preferred stock naman is a form of equity from a legal and tax standpoint. However, it differs from common stock in several important ways. So, take note class, ito yung pinakaiba niya. Preferred stockholder receive a fixed dividend that never changes. So, sa common stock kasi class, ang marireceive mong dividends is nakadepende kung ilang stock or ilang shares yung hawak mo. Sa preferred stock kasi, fixed. Preferred stockholders receive a fixed dividend. So, fixed na. Number two, the price of preferred stock is relatively stable. So, hindi nagbabago yung presyo ng preferred stock. Hindi kagaya ng common stockholder na paiba-iba every day. Preferred stockholder do not usually vote unless the firm has failed to pay the promised dividend. So, si preferred stockholder class has no right. Hindi siya pwedeng makavote. Naintindihan, hindi kagaya ng common stockholder. Pwede lang makavote si preferred stockholder kung hindi sila binayaran ng dividend. Next, preferred stockholder hold a claim on assets that has priority over the claims of common stockholder but after creditors such as bondholder. So, si preferred stockholder class is mas mauna siyang tumanggap ng dividend kaysa kay common stockholder. Pero, bago si preferred stock, unahin nyo muna yung mga creditor, especially yung mga bondholder. Siyempre, yung gobyerno by way of taxes. Only 25% of new equity shares are preferred stock and all 5% of all capital is raised using preferred stock. So, general class, ang preferred stock is ini-issue lang ng 5% of the total capital ng isang korporasyon. Next, how stocks are sold. So, paano natin ibebenta yung stocks? Unang-una, organized securities exchange. So, dito sa Pilipinas, Philippine Stock Exchange. So, dito ka magbebenta. Philippine Stock Exchange or PSE. So, stock exchange are central trading location in which securities of corporation are traded. These securities may include not only equity but also debt instrument as well as derivatives. Equity instruments can be traded if they are listed by the organized exchange that is included in the stock exchange trading list. So, paano mo malalaman kung yung isang corporation is listed yung kanyang shares? So, dito sa Pilipinas, tingnan nyo lang yung dyaryo under business column. So, nandun class yung mga corporation na listed companies. The lease is formed of instruments that satisfy the requirements set by the exchange, including minimum earnings.